Greetings, comrades! Soviet Gaming here. Today we are doing the scripts guide for Soda Dungeon 2. The scripts are basically changing of the character behavior in the way you want them to act. It will most likely make them more efficient if you make the script properly, and they will do so much better on autoplay. So this is what happened when my team managed to go through Dimension 7 with all those scripts. They actually managed to go through most of the levels, level 672, and the previous run managed to reach 699. So we basically got through all the journey on our second run when we just got the basic guys without the equipment. So that's how good the scripts are. When you want to create a script, you want to go to the arena. You should build it by now, that's for sure. And you go to the Soda scripts over here. And we have the default script that works for all the characters. Like, this is the behavior that is being scripted for everything. This is the default script and it can be modified. So you can see how your character behave when they meet someone, and you can base your scripts off that. So let's learn the basics from this. If enemies or your heroes will use pickaxe, that only concerns miners, because if those are not miners, they won't do that. If self HP is lower than 60%, they will use the strongest heal. If allies HP is lower 60%, they will use the strongest heal. This is for the healers and for your items that will heal others. If enemy team alive is bigger than 2, it means that if there are 3 or more enemies, your guys will use the strongest group attack. If enemy HP is higher than 90% of the health, your guys will use double strike. I think this is for a specific class. If enemy status is not negative, this means is not, your guys will use any debuff. If enemy rank is higher than mini boss, so basically that's the boss, your guys will use the strongest single target attack, so that will be like ultimate attacks, skills that consume mana. And if enemy isn't ore, use default attack. So basically this is a basic script. What I did, I created a script for every specific class, because you can make one script for everyone to use, it will be quite cumbersome, and I want some characters to act differently, so I decided to make a script for each class. I think it's way easier to customize it like that. And I started with the Mystic. My classes are 25+, so they have the second ability unlocked, and we're using Mystic for energy regen. So basically what we started here, we have ally and self mana lower than 60% use recharge. You might need to adjust that value for your character, because it totally depends on your overall mana pool. If it's too small, you want to use it earlier. But 60 seems to be like a sweet spot for me, because that doesn't allow her to use it all the time. Because if you put it too high, your Mystic will use that recharge even while the last one is ticking, and that won't be really good for you, because she will just burn out all the mana on that, and that's miserable. Now the next one, if enemy team alive is higher than 3, that's 4 and higher, basically 4, she will use the strongest group attack. I want her to use that AoE attack only when enemies are 4, not less. If there are 3, we will use a single target attack. For me, it seems legit, but most of the guys go for 2, so basically you will be attacking only if enemies are 3 and more. I'll leave it on 3. After that, if enemy is ore, she will use default attack. This is for the runs with the miners, because miners will make enemies ore, and you don't really want to spend your special skills on ore. I wanted to try to make this work, but it seems that in the current version, self MP doesn't work like that, so this is for the future. The developers said that they will fix that later, so you can use self MP and then use the attack skill, because right now, if self-MP is lower, you can only use something like heals, basically skills that affect your own character, not others. So instead of that, I went for enemy rank not normal, so with mini bosses and everyone higher, use strongest single target attack. I usually equip my Mystic with some weapon that does crazy damage, and since you have a high energy regen, that usually works. So you might want to include that if you want to be reliable, if you want him to be reliable, you don't want to equip your Mystic with any weapons that can consume mana. That way she will always recover everyone's stamina, mana, and she will be something like a battery for your team. And last one, enemy weakest use strongest attack, let's go with the default attack. So in all other situations, for all other enemies, for the normal ones, she will use the normal attack, because I don't want her to run out of mana that fast. Because that skill, at my current mana level, usually runs me down to lower than a recharge cost, and it doesn't work that well. So that's how the Mystic works. I'm not just showing you what to do, I'm showing you how to do this. So you can actually make a new trigger and optimize it for your own need, guys. We will actually create one script later with you together. If you want to delete some parts of the script, you click the one that you want to delete and click delete, and yes, there we go. After the script is selected, it's created, you want to apply it for your character. So for that, you go to this blue book, you go to the characters, you pick the one that you want to have the custom script, and you scroll over here for the script that you want. So for the Mystic, it will be Mystic Support. There we go. So right now I have scripts for Carpenter, Miner, Nurse, Mystic and Thief. I didn't work too much with Huntress and Dark Mage because those guys are nailing the game for me. I'm basically clearing the dimension in 2 or 3 runs right now, so I can't have enough time to use other classes. But yeah, let's go for other scripts so you can see how they work. Carpenter script, it's quite simple. Basically, if enemy is ore, use default attack. If enemy is weakest, use nailed it. If ore, use normal attack. If anyone else, just use nailed it. I'm using that attack on everyone and they don't run out of mana because I have the Mystic that recovers their stamina, their mana. So I don't want to use anything else. If you want to, I don't really recommend. You can add if self, where is it? Status. If self status isn't positive, so if they don't have the buff, they would use their specific skill, where is it? Sharpen. There we go. You can add this. That should improve your damage, but overall it will make your fights longer, so I don't want that. I will remove that. I want to go through levels as fast as possible, and for the bosses, for the last bosses, I'm usually fighting myself, so I don't need that automatic fight for the bosses. For the thief, we have pretty simple script over here. If enemy have essence, we will use ransack, because that will allow us to steal additional essence from the enemy, and when we kill them, we get extra essence. So that's basically double the essence from the essence enemies. And if enemy is not normal, like a mini boss or higher, use ransack as well. When you're running with the Mystic, that will work. If you're running without one, you might want to remove this one or put this to the boss, or I don't know, yeah, for the boss or dungeon boss, I guess. Because otherwise, your thief will run out of mana pretty fast. But that works. And everything else, basically, he will do the normal attacks, right? You might want to include this. So if enemy rank is higher than mini boss, use strongest single target attack, but it won't work because we have this one already for the normal guys. And she will use ransack all the time, so that won't work. But yeah, I mean, it doesn't really matter because mini bosses and bosses dying in a few hits, so you don't really need that at early dimensions. Later on, maybe we'll switch that a little bit, but that's the basic scripts right now that will help you to do so much better. Now, this one is really important. This is a nurse script. Nurse are like essential for you, so they will be alive and they will heal you. Let me show you what they have. First of all, if self HP is lower than 100%, use the group heal, because that's how she can heal herself. If you're running only one nurse, what I'm doing when I'm usually grinding or farming or doing whatever, you want her to be at max health, so she won't be one-shotted randomly when she's lower, and yeah, you want her to be okay. Second, if early HP is lower than 40%, use first aid. So if everyone is really injured, he got a strong hit, you can adjust it to 50%, maybe, I don't know, up to you. She will use a first aid that will fully recover someone's health. That's quite cool, right? And the next one, if ally HP is lower than 80%, she will use a group heal. That will basically make your heal your team and support their health. Usually it heals them to 100%, so seems good. And then I have this one. This is not really most effective, but I like it because I want to have poison on enemies. But you can go without this as well. Like, those three are the main ones here. If enemy rank isn't normal, that means that they will be mini boss, boss or dungeon boss, use biohazard, so she will try to apply poison on them. Make sure that the order of things is just like here. Like, your character will prioritize them, starting from the top one. And if this doesn't work, she will go for the next one and for the next one. So if you'll put this one on the top, instead of healing, she will be doing that action, she will be attacking. So make sure to get your buffs that you want to be up before the fight, before the enemy actions. Right. So yeah, you might want to include it, you might not, up to you. I have it, it's working pretty well for me, but maybe you want to do something different. Next one is miner. For the miner, it's really important to notice that if you want to have the mining team, you want to have several miners and not anyone else in the team. So probably the team for the mining will look like miner, mystic, Norse, miner, because that skill, enemy has essence, strongest attack, is important, so they won't turn the enemy who have essence into the ore. Now the next one, when enemy isn't normal, that for mini bosses and higher, they do the strong single target attack, that seems legit as well. And next one, for all other enemies, if enemy is ore, they will use pickaxe, that's natural, right? And now, this is interesting, here, if enemy team alive is higher than one, use the normal attack. That means that if there are 3, 4, 2 or whatever enemies, they will do the normal attacks. But if there is only one alive enemy, actually I have to put it higher. It doesn't matter, that one works. It doesn't matter where you place them actually. Yeah, if there will be one enemy, they will use transmute. And that will transmute enemy into the ore, and then this will work. So if enemy is ore, they will use pickaxe instead. That will allow you to get a lot of ore, but it will make your progress so much slower, guys. I tried to run this. It was like, I don't know, 5 times slower than usual. So, I don't know how useful it is at the early dimensions. Right now, I'm at dimension 7, I think. And I haven't found any use for ore so far. Because by the time I get enough ore to create something useful, I'm already finishing the Dark Lord. So, yeah, it doesn't mean that it's useful. Maybe at the later stages. But that's how it will look like for your mining team, guys. Maybe later on, I'll need to gather a lot of gold for the gold runs, for the gold shields and stuff, for the gold gems and everything, because right now I'm just using whatever I got from the dungeon. So with this knowledge, you can go up to dimension 8 no problem, because I almost cleared the dimension 7 right now. I haven't ever used this how is it called, blade master and dark mage yet, because I don't know, because I don't need them right now. But I know that those guys are really useful. I know that you guys who are experienced, who got past the dimension 10 and whatsoever, know that Dark Mage is really good because of your, I don't know this name of the skill, Toxin buff, whatever. And this guy, Blade Master, is doing crazy damage with his dual wield. But I haven't worked with them that much. I think they are not even level to the highest level for me. Let me see. Yeah, Dark Mage is level 9 and Blade Master is level 1. So right now, they are pretty useless for me. Oh, actually, Dark Mage's main skill is available for us right now, because I know people don't want to use Curse. Let's create Dark Mage script right now, so you will see how it works. So we go to the Soda scripts, creating a new script, and we will call it Dark Mage AoE. There we go. Create. So, okay, we will open up with AoE if enemy have more than 2 targets. You know how to do that, right? Enemy team alive is higher than 2, so it will be 3 and more enemies, and specific skill, where is Noxin, there we go, because everybody said that Noxin is really the best way to progress the levels the fastest, and then goes the laser, which I haven't unlocked yet, so that seems legit, right? Now new trigger, enemy rank isn't normal, use your strongest single target attack. All right, we want this one here as well, right? And don't forget about the ore, it's important. If enemy is ore, use default attack and put it on the top. If you want to change the order of the scripts, you press on the number and move it up. Simple. All right, so now what Dark Mage will do? When they start the fight, they check if the enemy is ore. If he is, they will use the normal attack. If not, they will check if they are more than 2. If they are, they will use Noxin. And then they will check if the enemy is boss or not. If the boss, they will use the strongest single target attack. It's really good for them, because those guys, they have 2 accessory slots. And that's really OP, guys. You might use it for something good, but I most likely will use it to boost my item find a little bit. As always, I'm greedy as hell. Yeah, but if you're going for the boss fight, you can use whatever you need for the current boss. For example, like element resist, or maybe higher defense, or maybe higher something, I don't know. But boost to magic damage for this guy, for this lady, I mean, for the Dark Mage, should be really good, because she have your own basic magic mastery, 25% boost to magic attack. So that makes Noxen really powerful because that's a magic attack and that will be boosted by her magic mastery. And for the Blade Master, I think you can use the normal setup for like you do for everyone. So yeah, since the Blade Master doesn't really have mana, every skill he uses makes him skip one next turn. And you want to use only one skill, I guess, because if you use stun and double strike, you'll just skip him stuff altogether. So do something like this. Enemy rank isn't normal, double strike. So he will use that on the mini bosses and the bosses. And yeah, enemy weak is default attack. That will do, because there is nothing special about the Blade Master, I think. But yeah, I haven't tried him yet, so I have no idea, guys. Let me know in the comments if you have any better scripts for him or for anyone else. Because, yeah, as you can see, I'm only at the end of Dimension 7, so I haven't got that far yet. But I hope that this guide for the scripts was useful for the newer players, for people who don't know how the scripts work. When I scripted my guys, they became like, I don't know, 5 times more effective, so I'm really happy that I spent like 20 minutes on that. And yeah, don't forget to apply those scripts to your characters here, otherwise they won't work. So yeah, you can go either with one huge script that will count in everything, or you can go for custom for everyone. I prefer the second variant. And yeah, let me know in the comments if you actually use scripts or you don't know how to do that, and if this guide was helpful. While you go in there, please leave a like to this video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet, make sure that the bell notification is turned to all, otherwise you might miss something. Also, if you want any more Soda Dungeon 2 guides, the playlist will be in the description and in the pinned comment. You will find other guides over there. And you might want to join our Discord to discuss the games or anything else with the community. This is basically my hub of all operations. You will see everything over there. And you might want to follow me on Twitch as well for the live streams. I'm streaming every Tuesday, Thursday and Sunday. On Sunday we have the multiplayer day when we play and stuff with everyone. You can join as well. It will be fun. And of course, join all my social media. All the links are over here or in the description. Thank you for watching, guys. Save it out. See ya, comrades. Bye.